this musicality lesson specially prepared for the Red Tango and Quality. We are Andres and Natasha.
We wanted to see you all in Belgrade, but we are very happy to share this opportunity with you from Paris and Lyon.
During this lesson, we will work about different dynamics, rhythms, phrasing, and we will try to give you some ideas to improve your interpretation, adding some qualities of movement.
Here we go.
For the first part, we will start with the beat. We have to be sure, first of all, that we share the same concept, because there is something a little bit different between musician and dancer. We don't count the beat in the same way. Depending on his score, most of the time, the musician will count twice faster than the dancer, for example. Let's hear an example with Don Juan de D'Arienzo. Okay, this is quite unusual for us because as dancer we will count more like this, music please.
So let's do this exercise taking the strong beats Natasha was talking about. Let's take 8 beats and let's do a phrase with it. We're gonna take 3 more phrases and each phrase we're gonna work in a different dynamic. So the first phrase we're gonna work every 4 beats, the second phrase we're gonna work every 2 beats, third phrase we're gonna work every strong beat, and the fourth phrase we're gonna work every strong and weak beat. The beat is in between every strong beat. So in the phrase will be something like this. It will be 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 1. Second phrase 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 1. Third phrase 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. And fourth phrase, it will be every strong and weak. It will be something like 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 5 and 6 and 7 and 8 and 1 and, be careful with that one, don't forget it, 1. So from here, we'll start over. 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's do it with music. Try to do it with us, this exercise we propose. So if you can pause the video, get ready, get your shoes, and get dressed perhaps. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 5 and 6 and 7 and 8 and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, and start over. Okay? So I let you to practice. Practice with saludos is a nice song to do it because the phrases are very clear. And it's very, the rhythm is also very clear. So take it, try to do the whole song doing this exercise. And if you can, try to take a video of you and check. You see the video and you do the phrase counting on this at the same time. If just to check if you are doing it well. If you want a challenge on top of this, I propose you to clap your hands on the fourth beat and just on the fourth beat. Pause and try it. And then check if it's something like this. Five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six. 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, and 2, and 3, and 4, and 5, and 6, and 7, and 8, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, check the video, be honest with you, and check that you really clap on the fourth beat, and just on the fourth, not on the eighth. Remember, it's just the fourth, and if you do something like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, it's something wrong. It's just the fourth. And the other thing that normally happens is like 1 and 2. No. Try to do it just on the fourth. Do the exercise and pay attention to the technique issues. We want to work with Natasha just after this, and pay attention if you really do it with the phrase. I'll let you with it. I'm with Natasha to explain how to do it better.
So let's try to dance a little bit more this exercise, because we already imagine you at home, and we imagine you a little bit stiff, no? Like counting and doing it more with your brain. So we would like you to make the movement the most fluid possible. Let's have an example. We don't like something like one, two, the whole step. So it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. For the every two beats. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Actually, you have different way to do that. Or you want to walk on the first beat, you walk, and then to make it fluid, something needs to happen in your body, so you cannot just take here. You can work, for example, with your free leg, connected of course with your basic leg. You can work with this leg to make the movement more fluid, to arrive to the next one. That is a possibility. on the four beats, for example, it could be 1, 2 to bring the leg, 3, 4, you already are here, 1, 2, bring the leg, 3, 4, 1. You could also decide to work much more on the transition, so how you will receive your weight, and we advise you to really work with your both feet in this case. For example, when I will walk, I don't want to pass to transfer my weight at once. I will really play with my both feet to make it the more gradual and the more smooth possible. So let's try for the fourth beat and the two beats. Let's try these two different ways. Walk at once and work with the free leg, or work with your transition with both feet. Okay, for the walking on the strong beat, we will try here to do it the more naturally possible. It means we want you to really walk and to displace yourself, move with the whole body. So it would not be one and I move like with my feet. No, I really want to displace and to move in the space with my axis. Okay, so it will be walk, walk, walk. And not too fast, not too slow. Try to find this timing in your body. Quiet. Okay, like you are in the garden with someone and you walk. Okay? For the last proposition, that was to be quicker, to come 1 in 2 and 3 and 4 and 5 and 6 and 7 and 8. It's you need really to move with the whole body and don't think about the position of your feet. It will not be something like no, this is like the geisha walk. No, we want to move with the whole body. Okay, so just try this kind of things. So to continue, we will have the third. Oh, sorry.
So, let's talk about the phrases and why are they important. We feel that normally when we see people dancing the milonga, they don't care so much. I mean, they try to be musical, but following different small things, like they feel the piano, and then 2 seconds later the violin, because they like the violin, and then the piano, and then the bass, and then, I mean, you are saying a lot of things at the same time. What we do with the phrases is to give some structure to this. That is the same structure the music actually is using. So in the music we have phrases of 16 beats, phrases of 8 beats, what use the most, and we can also use phrases of 4 beats. Take these phrases and like sentence when we are trying to write something or when we are talking. We want to keep the sentence, perhaps put some commas in between to make the message more clear. So, on the dance, it should be better if we adapt to these phrases. When to start something with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and we close it, and we talk, and we take this sentence as a message, as something we want to say. And this something we want to say, we can choose something on this phrase of the music we would like to express ourselves. Like, for example, the violin. We'll say, oh, I like the violin in this phrase, let's use the violin. We start moving, and then we finish. And the violin, what we wanted to say with the violin, is close. Then again, with the singer, or whatever you want to take, it shouldn't be just the music, it's something, a feeling you have or something you want to express, doesn't matter. But the music is what we use to express it. So, if we organize it, should be clear. Remember, first beat, we start, eighth, we finish. This could be general, we could use smaller phrases or longer phrases. Remember to attach to one thing and not to jump from one thing to the other. Let's see how we can use these phrases for melodic tangos or rhythmical tangos.
So we talk about the structure and the different rhythmical elements. Let's see now how we can use them depending on what we choose to dance. For example, if you want to follow the melody or the rhythm, we could use these elements in a very different way. Let's start with the melody, that it's something that we would like you to try to dance a little bit more in milonga, for example, because we don't dance it enough. We are really in the rhythm. Try. We will listen de mare, igual con mandoneo, and we will try to see what happened here. Beginning of the phrase. When we listen to this song, we realize that we cannot go faster or slower in any part of the voice, no? In any moment. We need really to organize what we are doing depending on the voice of the singer. So for example, let's see what happened exactly to see what we can do with this rhythmical element. One, three, four, five, seven, eight. Okay, so what happened? He's slowing down, no? He needs to breathe, and we can hear very well the first part of the phrase and the second part of the phrase. So the first exercise would be tense the phrase with him. We can listen that he's stopping at 7, yes? So let's try with music. We dance each strong beat until 7. And 7, we mark a pause, okay? Also, the moment when he breaths, it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So twice we will slow down, okay? At the same moment, all the time at the same moment, the 3 and the 7. Let's try to listen again. Quality to this suspension, not to this pose. For example, what we could propose you to do is to make a difference for the middle of the phrase and the end of the phrase. So, for example, the third beat, I will do it like a suspension. Like I will continue my movement, but I will do it on 2 beats. And on the 7, I will close the movement, like comma, point, end make really the difference. So it would do something. Then we'll do it with music. But 1, 2, 3, 4. Continue. 5, 6, 7, 8. And again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Let's try this music. The voice of the singer. Of course, you could decide to work with different dynamic also in the strong beat, like doing, I don't know, can we try with the music once again, please? For example. Okay, so you can go faster if you need in some moments, but really want you to mark the middle and the end of the phrase.
So let's see how we can apply the structure of the phrases with the rhythmical tangos. We're gonna use a song, it's called Tristeza de la Calle Corrientes, de Miguel Caló y Raúl Verón. And even though the music, the melody of the voice of Verón is very melodical, we have the rhythmical part of Caló very strong, and this will do it even stronger with a way to finish this phrase. This way to finish, it will be 7 and 8. It will change the dynamic, it will go faster to accentuate it, to make it stronger. That something is finished. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Can you see how the phrase is developing, is singing? And at the end, to finish, he go faster. Not just the singer, also the orchestra. And makes the end very clear. So, we propose you to, as an exercise, to do this, to dance. For example, with this song, it will be nice. To dance and apply this 7 and 8. You do whatever you want to do, and then 7 and 8. 8, finish, close, try to do this, ready, go. Then, we're going to take another way to do these phrases. We're going to do it like this, as an example. It's a very classical way to do the phrasing on the rhythmical tango. Let's do 1, 2, 3, and 4. 1, 2, 3, and 4. So we are taking phrases of 4 beats. You can count it like this, or if it's disturbing, you can do it in 8. For example, 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Example, it shall be 8. One, two, three, and four, five, six, seven, and eight. 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Can you notice how the music is using the same thing we talked before with Caló? It's going faster to make the end of the phrase stronger. It's something very useful we could use for rhythmical tangos. Also notice that how the singer is always feeling what he's singing on this mini phrases, let's call it like this, of two beats. So it's doing like 1 and 2, 3 and 4, 5 and 6, 7 and 8. So every go until on these ways, you can imagine for this way. So we propose you to get a tango, especially from the 40s will be easier, because on the 50s the music start going, it start being more complex, but from the 40s, the beginning of the 40s, and check how these waves are doing with the rhythmical and with the melodical, and listen to the song and do this way. For example, everything fits on these waves. And something it should fit too is the change of dynamic. Change of dynamic, for example, we do it on the back side front of the turn or ocho cortado. Sometimes we don't fit this very well. So it will be more useful if you know that the music has this structure. And for example, an ocho cortado, we could do it, we could use it like this. One and two, three and four, five, six, seven and eight. One and two, three and four, five and six, seven and eight. Do you see how it fits? It perfectly fits. It fits so well that it's difficult to imagine in another way. So something we propose you is to check a little bit more what is happening with all of this and do this exercise. For example, with this last part, to adapt whatever you are doing with the structure 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. You will find more sense of your movements with the music for you to do it.
We arrive to the third and last part of this class, and it will be about how we could improve our interpretation. So, of course, musicality is not only about phrasing, even if it's a very good start to organize our dance, organize our speech, as we saw before. Also to choose an element to follow, like the rhythm or the melody or different instruments, it's also a very good way to continue, okay, with this musicality work. But now we would be very interested in the feeling you will put, how you will dance what you have chosen to dance, okay? This is very important because this is also what will make your dance very personal. Why you will move like you move and not in the same way than your friends around or your teacher, okay? This is important. First, we could start to consider that there are different spirits and we could not dance everything in the same way. Let's start with orchestra, for example. We could not dance Pisani, like Flesel, Narienzo, Pugliese, Troilo, for the good reason that it inspires something different. And there is not any law to tell you how you should dance Pisani, how you should dance Flesel or Troilo. Okay? There is not any law. It should be like your way. What you should do, yes, is dance in different way depending on what you feel, what inspires you when you listen to the music. And the same for the instrument, okay? You would not dance to the piano in the same way that you would dance the violin, etc., etc. Okay, one thing that can help you at the beginning is to imagine, for example, some colors or some adjective that you will put on each orchestra or on one song in particular or on one singer, for example, okay? So for me, I should say I could say, okay, Preseo, I would imagine something pink and light and delicate, yes? Disarli would be blue and calm and elegant. D'Arienzo would be red and dynamic, like energetic, full of energy. Pugliese would be dark and deep and strong. And this is for me. You could feel something else, of course, and there is no problem with that, okay? I would be curious how Andres could explain that to you with very concrete example. So please, Andres, show them.
Let's try to apply Natasha's thoughts with very known orchestras like Disarli, D'Arienzo and Pugliese. So, first of all, it's Disarli for me. And if I have to do an analogy with some image, I will use something with water. And Disarli for me is like a lake. Very quiet, calm, relaxing and flat. If I have to express this on movement, I will do it, for example, with more transition between one step and the other. And if I want to do it more calm, I will choose to step every two beats. So I will do something like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, as we used before. Let's see with music. I hope it's visible for you. Now let's go, let's jump to D'Arienzo. I imagine D'Arienzo like the speed riggers, with a lot of speed and jumps and irregular. And my way, or one of the ways to express this, is at the opposite of this alley to do no transition at all and to almost fall on each step. Also, to do it more cut, it's not just about the transition, it's also the body. Cut like I'm freezing the movement each time. Let's do it with music. Express this rhythm that D'Arienzo has. We make it more visible, especially before and after the change of dynamic. Let's see how another example if I don't cut it. For example, if I do 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, and I keep the same dynamic with the same transition, we cannot see the rhythm very well. But if I cut it, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, it's more visible, more percussive. Let's go to Pugliese. Pugliese, for me, if we continue with the analogy of the water, will be more like the sea. Is this very calm part with the wave is preparing and falling again to restart. It has a lot of this change of dynamic, sudden change of dynamic from the very slow to the very fast and all the time like this. I like also for Pugliese to have a way of walking different from Disarli and D'Arienzo, that is something more like retaining the beginning of the movement and launching the step afterwards. It's like more like a bow with an arrow, keeping and throwing in. It will be something like this. Holding and go. Holding and go. And go. And go. And go. If we put it with the saddle, it will be more like this. The audience will be Pugliese. Let's see with music. So it has this very strong part. Go. Just examples. It's not the way to do it. There's just some ideas.
So let's see how we can dance this feeling. We think that one of the big mistakes is to cut the interpretation here in the low parts. It's like, okay, I will dance a lot with my feet and with my leg, but this is like you dance 50% of what you could do. We would like you to involve your whole body when you are doing something. Let's try with an example. If I want to dance something like intimate and delicate, okay? I think intimate and delicate. I could not dance it starting with my embrace here, for example. I could not dance it. Even if I will be very delicate with my feet, it would not be intimate at all. Okay, we agree on that, I hope. So it's not only about the way you will transfer your weight. Even if, of course, it's very interesting and it's very important how you will transfer your weight, because it will give a lot of different qualities. But we are really convinced that if you can make this quality travel until your hands, until your head, this gives you much more feelings, yes, and something much more that you can live for real, yes. So intimate and delicate, first I will think why my head would be there. No, intimate, I would be more with my partner or with my embrace, I would be more there, no? And maybe not during the whole song, but some moments, if I want one moment delicate and intimate, I will play with my whole body this idea. In the same way, if I want something very dynamic, for example, I could not hide with my partner and do something very dynamic with my feet. Like, there is nonsense, it's not coherent with my idea, okay? So what we would like you to try is really to express one idea with your whole body, from the fingertips, passing through the whole body until the hand, embrace until your head. Try to consider all this, and we think that it's what will allow you to give yourself much more in the dance. Yes, to have everything involved, and it's very important. We have to finish. We hope this class was useful for you and that it gives you many ideas to work on.
We hope to see you all at the Milonga very soon.
Thank you for your company.
Thank you, Natasha. C'est bon? I think this is the first time I took my pyjama off.
Today we will talk about musicality, about the rhythm, about the different.
Seguro.
¿Seguro, seguro?
Seguro.
Ok. The cat doesn't like me.